Dear students, welcome to Rats in Pathology. And we shall be continuing with our war on hematology. In the last class, I had given you an introduction to bleeding disorders. And in today's class, we shall be continuing with that. As mentioned earlier, the bleeding disorders can be because of vascular causes, platelet causes, clotting factor causes, or disseminated intravascular coagulation. We should have a very clear concept about it. And in today's class, we shall try to limit ourselves to these words: ETP, ITP, which can be acute and chronic. They can be asked as essay questions, short notes, or multiple choice questions. Let us not be bewildered and not make any mistakes in the examination. As promised, I shall be revisiting the topic any number of times. Please recall the mnemonic on thrombocytopenia. I remember platelets. I for immunological, R for radiation, P platelet disorders such as DAC, ITP, TTP. L for leukemia, A for aplastic anemia, T for trauma, E for enlarged spleen, hypersplenism, L for liver disorders, E for erythema, T for transfusion or therapy such as chemotherapy, S for sepsis. Normally you find a platelet is a cell without a head or a tail. That is how Robbins describes. And it is supposed to be very bland and harmless. But sometimes it can become active, an activated platelet, which can play havoc. We shall be seeing it in our counterpart on thrombosis later on. The first disorder is thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura. Synonym to this is thrombohemolytic thrombocytopenic purpura. An element of hemolysis is there. Another term that can be used is thrombotic microangiopathic hemolytic anemia. These are all synonyms. Please do not mistake the term thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura with ITP. It will be totally wrong. The etiology is unknown, and pathogenesis, there is an element of vascular endothelial injury, and there is also an impaired fibrinolysis. As a result of which, you find that there can be a clotting disorder. The features can vary from fever, fluctuating neurological disturbances, thrombocytopenic purpura, and hemolytic anemia. Initially, one or two can be positive, but towards the end, all will be seen. Fever, fluctuating neurological disturbances, thrombocytopenic purpura, hemolytic anemia. So much so, it is called a tetrad. And coming to the pathogenesis, it is seen in young adults, presence with bleeding manifestations, splenomegaly, jaundice due to hemolysis, petechial hemorrhages, and hyaline thrombus. So these will be the list of clinical manifestations, of which jaundice is most important because of hemolysis. Now going on to the pathogenesis, you find that these are all the platelets, wonderful warriors, and this is a von Willebrand's factor over here. And there is also an element called Adams 13. Now, what will happen in a case of thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura is there is a defect or a dysfunction in Adams 13, as a result of which you find there will be aggregation of the platelets around the von Willebrand's factor. And hence, there is a lot of intravascular thrombosis that can occur. At the same time, there can be some kind of bleeding manifestations elsewhere. What are you seeing on the screen? You find that the dried leaves are all flying. This is called a windswept appearance that can be seen in a dry weather when all the shed leaves are flying. This is seen in one condition called as hemolytic uremic syndrome, HUL. So this is exactly what will happen. The leaves are all fragmented, looking like poly leaves, and the entire thing appears to be flying in the air, which is called a windswept appearance, classical of hemolytic uremic syndrome, which is a differential diagnosis for thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura. The blood picture is, as I told you earlier, there is a hemolytic anemia, there can be thrombocytopenia. Bone marrow, cellularity is increased, erythropoiesis, everything is increased. So no difficulty at all. Megakaryopoiesis is also increased because there is no platelet in the peripheral blood. And the treatment is, you have to give plasma rich in platelets, fresh frozen plasma, and antiplatelet drugs. Sometimes because there can be antibodies to it. So this is what we see. And one day, I shall be a bygone dead who is still teaching the alive. A good saying that I picked up probably for myself. The next one is idiopathic thrombocytopenic purpura. The previous class, TTP, I was shocked when a student from one of the government colleges answered in a quiz competition and stole the prize. So you people should be careful. TTP is different from ITP, idiopathic thrombocytopenic purpura. It can be an essay, it can be a short note. It is an autoimmune disorder wherein there are autoantibodies binding to the platelets and they form immune complexes. We'll see what happens once immune complexes are formed. They undergo premature destruction by the spleen and the hepatic macrophages. And this is a skin of a patient suffering from ITP. I find multiple purpura means they are slightly larger areas of hemorrhage. Synonym, it can also be called as autoimmune thrombocytopenic or immune thrombocytopenic purpura. So any of these words can be given in the examination. Please don't get bewildered. And how do you know that it is an autoimmune disorder? You find that infants born to mothers with ITP, they also develop antibodies because the mothers will be having antibodies to the platelets and this will be crossing the placenta. Therefore, infants born to ITP mothers develop a thrombocytopenia. Patients whose plasma with ITP is transfused to normal recipients, you find that the normal recipients also develop thrombocytopenia because the patients with ITP will be having antibodies. Normal platelets, when they are given to a patient with ITP, they are rapidly destroyed because ITP patients have got antibodies. And ITP is finally diagnosed in patients with other autoimmune disorders. Whenever you see one abnormality, look for another elsewhere and you will find it. So this is the proof of pathogenesis. I would like you people to kindly memorize. It is not very difficult. And look at the reflection of it over here. Platelets are reduced. They are almost absent. In this picture, I am not seeing a single platelet. Maybe one is seen over here, but this is hardly sufficient. So it is markedly. Another group is over here. There is a marked reduction in the platelets. It can be moderately reduced or it can be severely reduced. Sometimes when it is less than 20,000, the patient can go in for spontaneous bleeding. So What are the highlights of it? The duration is it lasts for less than 6 months, more common in children and young adults. It can follow viral infections. Antiplatelet antibodies are found, and there is a marker reduction in the platelets. I think a simple list which we can very easily memorize. The investigations will be look for antiplatelet antibodies against the glycoproteins 2A and 3B. The prognosis as such is excellent. With supportive treatment, the patient will be recovering. So this is acute ITP, more commonly seen in children. And what is the pathogenesis? This is what I had said. So there are the antibodies which are being produced against the platelets, and the antibodies get attached to the platelets. So we call them as sensitized platelets. So the platelet itself acts as an antigen. These are the antibodies. So this is an antigen-antibody complex. Antibodies are immunoglobulins which are produced against the platelets. There is a complex of the antibodies and the platelet, antigen-antibody complex. Once a complex is formed, it remains stagnant in narrow sinusoids. That is what is happening in the spleen. In the spleen, you have got macrophages that are lining the sinusoidal spaces. And these will devour or eat the antigen-antibody complexes. As a result of which, you find that platelets get destroyed. This can also happen in the liver. So they get attached to the Fc receptor of the macrophages and they are destroyed. This is a basic, very simple pathogenesis, and I would like you people to kindly draw this diagram. And we had mentioned it, common in children, 2 to 6 years, following viral infections. Sometimes often after this COVID infections also, people can develop this ITP. Past history of measles or rubella. Antiplatelet antibodies are present. And there is a reduction in the platelet count. Bone marrow is mandatory for the diagnosis. Cellularity is normal because all the other cells are normal. Erythropoiesis is active. Leukopoiesis is normal. But when it comes to megakaryopoiesis, a lot of platelets are destroyed. Therefore, more of megakaryocytes are being produced. They are immature. They are rounded, hypolobulated with a basophilic cytoplasm. And the cytoplasm does not have much of granules, hypogranular. All the other cells are normal. Simple for you to remember. Only the megakaryocytes are abnormal, immature. Lymphocytes are normal, plasma cells are normal, mitosis is normal, ME ratio is normal. But this kind of a presentation I want you people to make for any description of a bone marrow. This subheading sangni. And look at this one. This is the patient. I'm sorry, the bone marrow of a patient with ITP. And the bone marrow, it is producing more and more of this megakaryocyte. Usually we have to search for them, but in one field I'm finding multiple, and they are all hypolobulated and immature, classical of ITP. And this is a normal megakaryocyte, an electron microscopic picture, and these are the immature megakaryocytes which are there. They are more rounded or hypolobulated, and the cytoplasm does not have granules. So a quote that you people can read if you have the patience. This I would like you people to again memorize. So what happens is, these are the platelets. There are antibodies which are being produced against the platelets. There are two cells, B cells, it produces the antibodies. So you find that there will be complexes which are formed. So the platelet itself is an antigen. There are the antibodies. So there is a complex that is getting formed. And there are the T cells which can cause a direct destruction. So two forms of destruction are there. Once there is an antigen-antibody complex, it gets attached to the macrophages and then it gets destroyed. Also, sometimes you find that there is an impairment in the maturation of the megakaryocytes. That is what I showed you in the bone marrow picture. So the T cells over here, direct cytotoxicity. B cells produce antibodies. opsonization, and then there is phagocytosis by the macrophages. Also, there is impaired megakaryocyte maturation. Very simple line diagram, easy for you to understand, and a list that you people can draw. All right. Mandatory, must. I think you people must not get less than 95% marks. Many smiling faces hide a bleeding path. Quotes that I have taken from bleeding. There are two diseases, acute and chronic ITP. So acute, as I mentioned earlier, common in children 2 to 6 years. There is no sex predilection. There is an antiviral history. Antecedent viral history. Onset of bleeding will be abrupt. That is why it is called acute. And there can be reactions. So eosinophilia or lymphocytosis is quite common. The platelets are very much reduced, less than 20,000. When I see the peripheral blood, I can hardly see them. Duration, 2 to 6 weeks. It is rarely very long. So it is self-limiting. A support treatment will be adequate and the prognosis is excellent. Chronic, on the contrary, occurs in adults. So the peak incidence is 20 to 40 years. Female-male ratio is 3:1. No viral history. The bleeding manifestation is insidious. That is, it is somewhat very slow in progress and suddenly noticed. Platelets are 30 to 80,000. Eosinophils are rare and the duration is for several months or years. Spontaneous remission is uncommon. Please by heart the differences between this. Whenever there are differences, kindly by heart, because this table can be used for acute ITP, chronic ITP, and so on. Chronic ITP, the highlights are duration is more than 6 months, young and middle-aged adults, females more common than males, 3:1 ratio, no viral precedence. And it is deciduous, gradual in appearance, menorrhagia, bleeding can be there. Sometimes intracranial bleeding, mucosal bleeding can be present. Petechia as well as ecchymosis. Ecchymosis means large blotchy regions of bleeding. And the blood picture is, because of bleeding, the hemoglobin is reduced. Anemia is initially normocytic, normochromic, but later on it becomes microcytic, hypochromic due to iron loss. And the platelet count I had mentioned earlier itself. In severe cases, it can become less than 20,000. Giant platelets can be seen, which are called as megathrombocytes. So, but these platelets somewhat compensate. They are hyperactive and therefore they prevent active bleeding. The differential diagnosis we should have in mind, at least one condition where you don't see platelets will be aplastic anemia. Please remember one differential diagnosis. The bone marrow aspiration, again the same set of subheadings. Cellularity is normal. Erythropoiesis is active. Micronormoblast because of iron deficiency. Leukopoiesis unremarkable. Abnormal cells are nil except the megakaryocytes. They will be having the abnormalities, which is mentioned over here. So megakaryopoiesis is normal or increased as a reaction. They are hypogranular and a basophilic cytoplasm. Nuclei are small and hypoglobulated. No platelet budding is seen. Differential diagnosis will be other causes of thrombocytopenia, such as aplastic anemia, to be excluded. A bend in the road isn't the end of the road unless you take a wrong turn. A beautiful quote which I like, and I have mentioned it in my hematology text also. And always when there is something like bend of a road, etc., you find that there will be a movie or a book with that title, and that is what I traced. The Senthak. Thank you.